All right, guys, we've been dodging storms today, but we did get to go where we wanted to come, which is somewhere that I've been really excited to see, actually. And it's not much, but it's kind of special. Encountering some severe weather here, so. Basically dodging storms right now, trying to come up with an alternative plan, because it seems like where we want to go is not the place to go right now. Look at this fucking, that is like a fucking tornado.
Yeah, a little baby, coming right into it. That's crazy.
Shit, dude. So during the war, right after Pearl Harbor, Americans kind of freaked out and wanted to inter Americans of Japanese origin or descent and separate them from strategically important areas. So their way of doing that was basically forming internment camps all over the country, 70-something internment camps, and they actually forcibly removed 125,000 Japanese Americans. So many of these camps would have been under the administration of different branches of the government, the War Relocation Administration, the Justice Department, the military, etc. And so the conditions at the camps varied widely, but some would have classes, allow college students to go off and attend their schooling, or even get jobs off of the camp. Sadly, there were many incidents of violence at the camps because the conditions could be less than satisfactory. And there was actually even a riot, many different attempted escapes, and one man was killed at this site working in the forest by a farmer who I guess maybe freaked out that there was a Japanese man in the woods outside his farm. So, oh gosh, it's windy. When the federal government first approached the governor of Arkansas about having this camp in Arkansas, he was pissed and refused because he was racist and didn't want Japanese people to stay in his state after the war. But so the federal government had to reassure him, don't worry, we're gonna kick out all the Japanese from Arkansas and send them back to California, where we kicked them out of. So eventually he agreed, and the two internment camps that were built in this area were built, and they were built pretty quickly. There was such an hysteria that the American public didn't want the Japanese prisoners to be treated well. So the War Relocation Administration deliberately set the daily budget per person at like 25 cents a day or something low like that. And so the prisoners would have to manage the acres of land outside of this particular camp to grow produce to supplement the food at the camp. And I mean, still today, this is all entirely agricultural area, as you can see. Like I said, the conditions here at the rower site were probably not the worst of the internment camps, but it was definitely imperfect. So you can see here a kind of rendering of what the camp would have looked like. And looking out there, you can see in the distance, hopefully, is the smokestack. Out there in the distance is the smokestack left of the hospital. And then you can imagine kind of what the camp would have looked like. So there was a school built at this site because so many of the internment camp prisoners were actually school-aged children. But the government failed throughout the entire war to have enough teachers on staff to actually adequately staff the schools. I mean, a lot of it had to do with the fact that they were in incredibly secluded and rural areas. And sorry for the wind, guys. We've, like I said, been dodging storms all day today. That still might actually be a tornado. We probably shouldn't be out here. This is just the memorial for the Japanese who were interned here, but actually served for the U.S. Army and died in World War II, which is kind of highlights the deep irony of the internment camps in general. Here you can see the names of the Japanese soldiers, well, American soldiers, who died for the U.S. Army. And here, actually, you have a Japanese memorial. You can see even the iconography in this memorial is really cool. Important people were interned here and went on to become great people later in their lives. People like George Takei, Rose Ochi, poet laureates, painters, lawyers, civil rights activists, actors. So it's actually quite amazing. Here actually are the graves of the people who died at the camp during the war. The Japanese were actually subjected to loyalty questionnaires that asked them if they were loyal to the emperor or that if they were good U.S. citizens. So many of them were actually U.S. citizens, and in 1944, the Supreme Court ruled that the internment of U.S. citizens was illegal and unconstitutional. And since the 40s, the United States government, through various steps, have taken means to pay out the survivors of the camps. So I believe something like $1.6 billion has been sent to the thousands of Japanese people who are still alive, who were interned in various camps during World War II. And actually, when the camps were closing down, the government was basically kicking people out. And many of the Japanese people only received $25 and a train ticket back to where they came from. Thanks for being a prisoner. Crazy. And actually, few people know, but there were actually German and Italian Americans who were forcibly relocated too. But by far, the Japanese were the largest number. So like I said, it's a real grave injustice, and it's barely remembered today, but 125,000 people were forcibly relocated, citizens, American citizens, by the U.S. government. And like I said, it's not really remembered today. There's not much here you can see. And a lot of what these memorials were actually put up by the people themselves who were interned here and spent years of their life here. Like I showed you before, the graves of the people who died here. There were babies born here, and now it's just gone. It's been erased. It's just very beautiful. And like I said, it's kind of heartwarming. I don't know if that's the right word, but to know that these Japanese people who had their loyalty questioned, their citizenship ignored, forcibly relocated by their government, their families might have been living in these camps, but they still volunteered to fight for the American army, and they went off to die in France and Italy and Germany. Just another piece of America's kind of forgotten history. Right now, I think we might be camping like kind of unsmartly in a tornado potentially, but I think it's fine for right now. We're gonna play it by ear.
Close.
Okay, so it's got it kind of high hidden in there. Just sweet potatoes, man.